my name is Nick Pistone. I own a Pistone Scrap Processing. We're out here cutting metals all day long, and today we used a powder torch.
I was cutting with it, and it was going real good. And then I turned it off, and I found it doesn't work very good without it.
What would you normally use on that machine base?
Regular 4,000. Or the
It's going to take just 25 minutes to make a cut like that.
Like right here, I wanted to just do a comparison.
Yeah.
So I was cutting. It cut real nice, and then right at the bottom, about an inch, I went without it just to do the comparison.
Yeah.
And it's nice. There's really no comparison.
Night and day.
Yes.
Did it go right through this 316 then?
Yeah, it cuts like you're cutting normal steel.
So basically cut essentially like butter?
Yeah, it's and the same with cast on that thinner stuff, it cuts like regular steel. Real close.
What is that again?
It's Chromoly. It's from Chromoly. The rollers. It's a hot.
That's the hardest mill
roll.
The hardest mill roll that they make.
It's straight from Cleveland Cliffs.
Is that manganese?
That's dead iron.
Manganese, yeah.
Manganese usually cuts pretty easy unless it's got some nickel.
Well, it's not that. You lose the bead with it, you know what I mean? You'll be cutting on it, next thing you know, you'll lose the bead.
Right.
I just want to see if it doesn't lose the bead on it.
See,
what's that thing right there?
It's a chrome roller.
It's pretty oily.
Well, it's not that it's oily, it's just chrome coated, you know?
Shines is on the stainless and the high nickel. The cast will help, but I can cut some cast without it. I cut down about 6 inches and then I shut it off and then I cut some more without it.
Yeah.
So stuff like that, it does help when you're just getting it started, but once you got a little heat to play with, it's not impossible to cut it without it.
Sure.
But the stainless and that high chrome, that stuff typically doesn't cut without melting it or that powder.
I mean, you went through it so quick.
I'll set a piece of steel on top of it and I'll use the heat from that in order to burn through the surface.
Yeah.
So, you know, I'm over here lugging around 40, 50 pound pieces trying to prop it up on top of this mill roll so I can cut through it, you know?
Yeah. Literally what you're doing is the powder. It's a lot lighter and a lot easier.
Man, that's crazy.
This cast is pretty hard too, normally.
Yeah. This is not as hard, but still.
Yeah, that went pretty fast.
A lot of people can't always get the grasp of cutting that cast.
Yeah.
And then that stuff is really hard for a looking problem. And then it cuts through that stainless real nice. Oh, and whenever I was cutting this chrome cylinder,
yeah.
Typically you'll have to heat through it, get through the chrome, and then when you're on the inside of the chrome, it'll push through. But then to back drag down, it's hard to do that because it doesn't eat away at the chrome.
Yeah.
So then I turned on the powder, and it went right through it.
Nice.
So it was really nice to cut through that chrome on a cylinder.
So how much time do you think it would save you if you had to cut any of this, if you were cutting this for the day?
If you was geared up to cut just stainless, you would be 200%, I would call it, because you could do it half the time with the powder.
Yeah.
So we cut some stainless steel, some 316s, 304. We cut some cast iron. We cut some dead iron / manganese out here. We also cut through some not just regular cast. We also cut through some pot irony cast, stuff that's pretty much breaks pretty easily when you touch it, but is a real pain to cut with the tools. And we also cut through some chrome coated rolls. And cut through some pipes, and basically cut everything pretty much essentially like butter. And we also cut a piece of a Chromoly roll, which it cut that thing like butter, and that's the hardest mill roll that we happen to get out here. So I'm pretty impressed by it.